Hi, and welcome to Rich Media Design Production Tutorial. Today we're going to talk a little bit about QR codes. It's their importance in today's advertising, and the fact that you can now get QR codes to do specific things. And for example, QR code can actually dial direct to your business. If you had a QR code on a business card, for example, you can actually have that scan. If somebody had a reader on their smartphone, or they had a QR app on their phone, they can scan that QR code. Lost myself for a minute. And they can actually dial direct with that QR code. That's specifically what you want. And if you wanted a QR code, you can actually go online, type in free online QR code generator or something, and I'm sure there are hundreds of them out there. If not on the first page, you'll find 10 or 15 of them, and you will evidently get one that can generate a QR code for you for free. These generators will ask specific questions about your business or what you wanted to do specifically. So, if you're interested, go ahead and get into it, get yourself a code, you'll be on your way. This today will be a lesson on how to modify your QR code. Now, when I say modify, I'm really talking about embellish, because you can't really modify the code too well or too much. I've been told that you can modify or change things up to about 30%. I've seen where the middle of the design or this particular codec is taken out, and then a name is put in there. There's some neat little tricks that people can do, but if you do too much, it won't work. It won't be read. So I have a feeling that it's more of about 30 instead of 30%, about 10%. But anyway, this is about modifying or embellishing your QR code, and I've taken some steps to take my QR code that you are looking at there and modifying it or customizing it for my business, which is Rich Media Design Production, and specifically for you to go directly by looking at this particular QR code to my YouTube channel. And here's some things that I've decided to do. I decided to get an old vintage television set. I'll take you down so you can look at it. And as you can see, I've already done some work on here. So, I'm taking some steps ahead, so I won't take too much of your time. And added my business, a copyright 2011, and the YouTube channel that this is going to take you to. Okay. The next thing I did was I got a Indian head test pattern. This is the old, vintage test pattern that people used to see on their television when the television station would sign off. And for some of you that never saw this before, it's too bad, because this was nostalgic. Anyway, I've seen it, so maybe I'm giving my age away a little bit, but so what? We're all gonna get old. Anyway, here is my logo, my QR code, not my logo. And this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put this QR code in the center of this test pattern. Take the test pattern and put it into the vintage television set that I'm going to use as maybe an outro or maybe even intro to some of my videos in the future. Okay, so here's what we'll do to get started. First, I'm going to take this guy here and go up to select and press select all. Then I'm going to go and say Command C, copy, or you can go to File and say Edit, copy. You can see where it says Command C there. And I've already copied it. Then I'm going to go to the Indian Head test pattern, and then I'm going to delete the middle. Now, if you notice, I've already had it selected, and I'm already gonna, you know, just go for it and delete it. So, how I derived that data, I'll just go over it with you real quick. Go back, and here's what I did: I selected elliptical marquee tool. Okay, and if you notice, I have some margins that I've set up, horizontal and vertical. I took the inside of the circle ring right there, the black circle ring, and then I went over here to the top left corner, and then I press shift so that I can hold a perfect circle proportion as I pull down, and I'll do it again. That when I got to the bottom right hand corner, it hit exactly where I was before. So anyway, that's that. Then you let go of your mouse and the shift key, and you should have that place there. Then you go ahead and press deselect. The fill window will come up, and it'll ask you if you wanted to erase or take away the middle with the foreground color, background color, or a color that you can choose from there, black, 56% gray, or white. I say white, okay? Why? Because white background is perfect for what I want to do. Okay, so go ahead and say okay. Now I'm gonna go back to the our QR code, since I have to say, Command copy again, because I went over to this Indian head pattern and started working on it again. I lost that copy I just did. Anyway, I recopied it. I go to paste and paste special, and then I'll say paste into, which is a good idea, because that way you could paste within the circle, and outside of that circle, where, like, say the Indian head is and everything else, all those lines and stuff, will serve as a mask. So here's what I mean. See the middle? Now it has the QR code, because I said paste into. But obviously the QR code is bigger than the Indian head test pattern that we have on screen now. So what I want to do now is press transform scale, and it'll scale the test pattern. Remove this layer over here so you can see what's going on. Now I'm going to go ahead and press shift so I can scale everything down in proportion. This probably I could, but for the sake of simplicity and for sake of, you know, not jeopardizing the QR code's integrity of being read, I'm gonna leave it alone and kind of work with maybe some ideas at some other time. So anyway, I'll go ahead and flatten this. So I'll go over here on the layers and go over here to this corner here, press it down, and see the menu item, flatten image. Flatten image brings it all down. Okay, then I'm going to go over here and say select all, press copy, command copy. Then I'm going to go over here to the TV set. Now, remember that test pattern was white, so what I want to do is add white to the middle part here. And so I'm going to take a paint bucket tool here on the left, and then I'm going to switch. If you notice, I had white and black here. White was my foreground, black was my foreground, white was my background, which meant that anything that I was going to work with or paint or draw with is going to come from the foreground color, which is now black. So here I'm going to switch it so that anything I work with will now be white. And since I have the paint bucket switch on, I can go ahead and press the paint bucket tool down with my mouse, and it should fill up nicely here. Perfect. Okay, now since I have that, I can go ahead and take my magic wand, press the middle here, and select it. Okay, go back to Indian head. I think I remember I still have it selected, but I'll reselect it. Go back to the vintage head and then paste it again. Where's my paste at? Sometimes, you know, you forget where things are. Okay, paste in two again, and there, paste into the TV channel. Now, here, as opposed to the first time, the image is smaller than the image you're pasting into. And so what do we want to do? We want to transform it, scale it up, and here's what we do. Once you like that size, which is pretty good, I guess I can go put it down here. Okay, if you like that, then just double click in the middle after you've scaled it, double click, and that should lock it in place. And there you have it. Now, I can go ahead now and flatten the whole thing, and that'll work perfect for anything else I want to do to make my outro or intro to my web YouTube animations or videos. Hope you had a good time with this, and it's a good introduction to QR codes and some of the things you can do with QR code to kind of embellish it for your own personal use.